Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to make meatloaf for dinner. So these are all the ingredients that I'm going to use. I have my milk here. I have my barbecue sauce, my ketchup, my honey mustard. That's for the sauce. These are the seasoning, my black pepper, my all purpose, my accent, and I have 2 slices of bread, and I have 2 eggs, my green pepper, red pepper, my onion, and my garlic. And this is the mince that I'm going to use. So guys, let's get started. Okay guys, so I have the bread. The bread is going to what I'm going to soak in the milk, and that is going to give the meatloaf, hold the meatloaf together, as you said. So I'm just gonna go ahead guys and break up my bread and pour the milk in it and set it at the side, and then I start to cut up the rest of my stuff. Just push it aside and let it go, let it soak so it can break up easily in the meat. Okay, next I'm just gonna go ahead guys and I'm going to start to do my seasoning. And I am going to cut up those green pepper, red bell pepper, as I said before, onion, and my garlic. And also I am going to saute them. When I cut, I'm going to saute them. I'm not just going to put them inside the meat just like that. I'm going to saute them with some butter and garlic. And I'm using my purple onion, guys, because the purple onion give it a different taste than the white onion. So I already cut up my garlic, guys. And the garlic, I'm just going to melt the butter in the garlic and saute them. So I'm just going to go ahead and cut them up, and then I get back to you.
Every time I try to make it on my, every time I try to stand, start to fall. And all those lonely roads that I've traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. Well, there was Jesus. In the way, and in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Well, there was Jesus.
There was Jesus.
In the way, in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in.
Okay guys, so as you can see, I finished sauteing all my seasoning. Now I'm going to season up my meat now. And guys, I'm gonna use the same seasoning that I normally use over and over. You guys can use any seasoning that you want. It's up to you. You are the one who cooking, okay? So you have to just know what to use.
I'm not perfect, so I thank God every day.
So now guys, I'm going to pour in my bread that I soak in the milk. It's very soft. I'm just going to pour it out, and I'm going to mix my egg and pour it also in it. So I'm just using two eggs and I'm using a different container to just mix the egg up. You could have just break the egg and pour it over the meat, but I don't want to. When I start to mix the meat, it gets soft, so it's best for me to just beat the egg, if you understand exactly what I mean. Oh, so a piece of my the shell get into the egg, so I'm using the same shell and just pick it up. It's very easy when you use the shell to take it up than to get a fork. I'm just going to beat it up and just pour it all over, and then I'm going to pour in my seasoning in it, the one that I saute on the stove, and then I'm going to dig into it. Guys, you can use your gloves or you can use your hand. As long as it's clean, you're cooking for your family, so you can use your hand or your gloves. It's up to you.
In the way, in the searching, in the healing and the hurting, like a blessing buried in broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know, I couldn't see it. There was Jesus on the mountain, in the valley. In the shadows of the alleys,
there was Jesus.
In the fire, in the floods,
there was Jesus.
Always is there.
So guys, here I have my baking tin and I'm just gonna pour everything out in it. I'm not gonna grease the baking tin because this meat here have a lot of grease. So I'm just pouring it out and I'm going to shape it in the form of a meatloaf. And a meatloaf shape is like a bread shape. Okay, so I'm just gonna shape it. My oven is already set at 350 and I'm gonna put it in. I'm not gonna cover it. Put it in and let it stay there about an hour and a half. And then I am going to start work on my sauce. So
I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. Well, there was Jesus. In the way, in the searching, in the healing.
So guys, I have a container here that I'm going to mix my sauce in. And I just have a little bit of granulated sugar. You can use brown sugar because I don't have any brown sugar right now. That's why I'm using the white sugar. And I'm just pouring like ketchup. I'm eyeballing, guys. I'm not measuring. I know the amount of sauce that I want to make. And you will know the amount that you want on your meatloaf. And I'm using some barbecue sauce over it. As I said before, no measuring. And I also using some mustard. I'm not a huge fan of mustard, but the mustard, it take it to another level. And I'm just going to whisk it together and set it aside until the meatloaf bake. Then I just spread it over the meatloaf, pop it back in the oven for another 15 minutes, and then the meatloaf is finished. And also, what I'm going to eat with this for dinner is some garlic mashed potato. That's what I'm going to use.
The broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it.
So, okay, guys, after 1 hour and 20 minutes, this is it. Look at the amount of grease that come from this meat here. So I'm just going to pour this grease off and I taste it and it's cooked. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pour the grease off and then I'm going to pour my sauce on top of it, just on the top. And then I'm going to pop it back in the microwave for another 10 minutes.
In the way, in the searching, in the healing, in the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been or where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it. This man who needs a major kind of
this is a finishing look. You don't want to smell in my kitchen. It smells so good. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Remember to run over to YouTube and subscribe to my channel, Opal the Francis Family. And I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye, guys.